outdated textbooks, some published nearly 30 years ago, well, they are still being used in classrooms across our state.
That is what our chief investigative reporter Morgan Lowe discovered when he looked into our struggling public schools.
Arizona teachers went on strike last spring, demanding more money for the classroom.
Well, it's a good day for teachers in Arizona.
They got their raises, but school budgets are still tighter than they were 10 years ago. And lots of schools are using textbooks that are older than 10 years. We sent a survey to every school district in the state asking for the title of their sixth grade social studies text and the year it was published. 47 districts responded. Half of the texts in use were published before 2008. Six were published in 2001. One published in 1990. Eastern Hemisphere, the world around us, was written before Bill Clinton even announced his run for the presidency. It lists Muammar Gaddafi and Fidel Castro as current dictators. Both of them are dead, and shows George H.W. Bush as the current president. Some districts reported that they don't even use textbooks anymore, that their teachers find the material online.
Is it that simple to just say, well, we have an old textbook, but we're going to bring in some other information?
I think it could be, I don't want to say simple, that's not the right word.
Diane Douglas is the state superintendent of public instruction. She says it's possible to replace or add to textbooks with teacher research, but there needs to be some oversight.
Not just any teacher go out there and find what will augment you from President Obama up through now or the 1990s up through now.
If you're wondering why teachers are having to do this to begin with, the answer is that textbooks are expensive.
We spent about $1.2 million.
Angelina Canto spoke to us via Skype. She is the assistant superintendent of the Nogales Unified School District, where they are incorporating technology, things like e-books, to reduce the costs of traditional textbooks. But that doesn't work for every district or every student.
Certainly some of my students may not have access to technology at home, so that would be one challenge related to that.
Every school administrator we spoke to said new textbooks and new curriculum often get put off when they compete with needs like new roofs, air conditioners, and buses in a time when budgets do not cover every need.
Some districts are finding money to buy new textbooks and to upgrade their curriculums, but many of those districts are doing that with local school bond money. They are not relying on money they get from the state. Seen, Chris?
It is unbelievable that those books are still being used. Very eye-opening. Morgan Lowe, thank you.